haven't seen the last of those bastards. But when they attack again, we'll be ready for them. Good girl.
Could you even... You couldn't even get anyone in that thing.
Someone's got himself in trouble.
I don't see your master here, so you can start by giving us all the coppers in your purse.
I already told you, I have nothing.
Then maybe we'll take that pretty outfit and the steel you're wearing.
Hey man, how's it going?
Please! These men are trying to rob me!
I'll deal with this.
Thank you.
You that one's master then? If you kindly pay the coin he owes us, we can pretend you didn't draw your blade on Republican soldiers.
I don't think you know who I am. The one guy who's like super into it on the left hand side.
Oh, you're more than welcome to. He hasn't had many visitors since we slit his throat.
There we go. Easy. Easy as pie. As beer.
I'd expect as much from Hugo's faithful, but these were men of the fist.
Much has changed in the Republican army since they lost their rock.
You've seen this kind of thing before then?
Many times. I was sent here to observe the situation.
One of Rutherford's men. He sent me to look for you.
Well, then you have my thanks. I fancy I could defend myself against one, perhaps two, but a whole regiment. I arrived in Dunamill several days ago, but when I called upon the captain of the local garrison to make inquiries, his men confiscated my effects and locked me in a cell.
The captain is no more, and his men make the rules now.
Fortunately, I was able to bribe my way free, only to be stopped again by those soldiers you so kindly dispatched.
What of the Fist Central Command? Surely they wouldn't allow such lawlessness amongst their ranks.
I would imagine they are unaware of it. Most of the army has fallen back to the capital and hunkered down behind her walls. Those who weren't recalled now rule the fringes unchecked, answering to no one but themselves.
And it's worse than we imagined. You should return to Rosaria. It's not safe here.
I'll find a caravan heading north. You won't mind if I borrow one of these soldiers' coin purses?
Not at all.
I mean, you just took it and left anyway before even saying anything.
To find this second associate of Rutherford's. If he was bound for Oriflam, I'll start at North Reach and see if I can pick up his trail.
I was just at North Reach, though. Jeez, that far away? I was just at North Reach.
There's a lot of road between here and the capital. Rutherford's man could be anywhere.
They'd have us believe. Your best part believing in ghost stories. Young Jack Sparrow. Cause you're in one.
Let's go. Yeah.
I guess if you kill one, the other one dies, I guess.
Safe.
What happened here?
If you're with the others, they've already relieved me of my belongings.
I'm not. I'm looking for someone who was sent here by a man named Rutherford.
And then you found him. I'm Alastair Rockford, attendant to the Lady Ariane of House Wellesley.
Of the Seven High Houses of Rosaria. It's been a long time since last I saw my great aunt. Is she well?
My Lord Marquis? Yes. Yes, she is. The Lady Dowager has granted me leave to assist your Uncle Stuart. I was on my way back from the old capital when I saw some villagers being robbed on the road here.
Bandits?
They looked more like field hands, but it didn't matter in the end. I did what I could to help the victims, but all it earned me was a pommel to the temple.
Which way did they go?
South, toward the gate.
All right. I'll take care of them. Fauna knows I've met enough of their kind. You head back to Northreach. Visit the Vale. Tell them I sent you.
Thank you. I shall. Founder, be your shield.
I am the shield. I don't need a founder for it.
Come on. Fly, Ambrosia.
They just couldn't resist, could they?
We're literally right there.
This one's ours.
No, we want you all here. Come on. Everybody gets to be a part of the party. This is like as much as I ever get.
Thank you.
This guy is tanking the entire thing. I think it glitched. I think he's glitched. He's literally not doing anything. Oh well. This man's whole career took 3 point blank specials in the face.
Make for the town while you can. There may be more bandits nearby.
You don't need to tell me twice. Many thanks, traveler.
Tell them twice.
This looks to be all of them.
I thought I told you to make for the Vale.
And stand by as ill might befall the heir to the ducal throne.
It's just Clive. And I'm fine. Which is more than can be said for you.
I will survive.
I will survive.
Strange that the garrison would intervene in such a brazen attack so close to their gates.
The garrison have their hands full inside the city. Some days they don't even send out patrols. There are few hands left to work the fields, and even fewer to transport the grain. The market stalls are nearly bare, and the price for what remains is exorbitant. It's not uncommon to see a fight break out over a crust of bread. When I said the ones who attacked me didn't have the look of bandits, I meant it. They were probably just desperate.
Rockford, listen to me. If you are to continue your investigation, you first need to seek the attention of a healer.
Of course. I shall return to Northreach right away. But allow me to thank you first. Had you not happened along, I...
Don't thank me. Thank Rutherford. It was he who sent me.
I suppose he'll be wondering where I've got to. I shall send a Bastolus as soon as I'm able.
Good morrow.
My uncle certainly has his work cut out for him. If it isn't already too late.
My guess would be to reinstate Rosaria.
But his colleagues are still in one piece.
Still gotta do the Dalmachian quest. I'm actually remembering all of the maps, like parts of the map, which is great. So we're going back to Rosaria.
I see you're still here.
The rest's location affords a constant flow of traders, and with it, a constant flow of information. Speaking of which, I received word from both my associates. They have resumed their investigations, thanks to you.
I only happened to be in the right place at the right time. They both seem to think the realm's prospects rather grim.
I am afraid that grim would be putting it lightly. Storm is in crisis, and if we are to free her, we must work quickly. And we must work together. Such is your Lord Uncle's wish.
as it is mine.
Now the question will be, do I save my points with the eventuality of having to get the next thingy, or do I get mastered up? Well, at least that's... We finally... Oh. Yes, icon! Queen! Okay. We at least have one thing mastered up. Probably gonna regret it later. But... At least the points are being used. More than I could have asked for, really. Right. Time to do this one.
Charmer ain't letting anyone through.
Why, the gate's closed.
Chief's orders. No one's allowed in without his say-so. Not that I'd have let you in anyway. You look like trouble. I suggest you go home.
That's what I'm trying to do, you little prick. You ain't changed a bit, have you, Snotty?
No. It isn't. Blackthorn.
Long time no see, eh?
What the hell are you doing here?
Well, it was meant to be a surprise, but since you are so nicely, I'm here to see Zoltan, you fucking monster.
Jeez, Blackwell.
All right. Just don't go starting anything with the chief.
Yeah, I promise I won't throw the first punch. Not good enough for you.
Cheeky Muppet.
Go on then.
Much obliged.
Did he need to open both doors? Was that necessary to this situation?
This is Dravosht. Not much going on, is there?
It's a smithing town. When I was a lad, you'd have to shout to be heard over the sound of hammer on anvil.
It's quiet.
Clive, you're good with people. You speak to Sultan.
Hey,
Clive.
You ain't backing out now, are you?
There's a river of bad blood between me and the chief. If someone can build me a bridge, then I'll cross it.
All right. I'll see what I can do.
You're good with people.
I appreciate it.
Tell the most introverted Final Fantasy protagonist ever.
It was our masters. He'd have inherited it when I left.
Forge on the hill.
Good luck. You'll be needing it.
But if we can't fire the forges, how are we going to earn our keep?
Mama?
Hotter! Hotter, damn it! Those miserable flames wouldn't melt butter, let alone iron!
Oh.
Pardon the intrusion. I'm looking for the chief.
That'd be me.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
I'll bet it is.
He sounds like
Gates my closed, I tell him. Well done, Snotty. You're not welcome here. Get out. Before things turn nasty.
Blackthorn's here.
What did you say?
He's traveled a long way to see you.
Yes, has he?
He's waiting. Down by the gates.
Then I suggest you take him with you when you leave.
Didn't you apprentice together?
So what if we did?
Fuck! We're getting nowhere! These bearers' flames are next to bloody useless!
We're never going to be able to fire up the forges unless we can find some new crystals.
I'm a busy man, as you can see, so do me a favor and piss off. Oh, and if you're struggling to find your way out, ask Blackthorn. That prick knows exactly where the exit is. He's not wanted here. And neither are you.
All right. I'm going.
I think it's because he's been using crystals and Blackthorn just uses his hands.
Let me guess. Zoltan told you to piss off.
As a personal favor to him, yes.
Well, at least he didn't beat about the bush.
There'd be no talking him round. Not after what I did.
Which is what exactly? If we're to help, we need to know. What turned the village against you?
I left. Dravosht. Zoltan. The burden of leadership our dying master dropped in our laps. All of it. There are two kinds of smiths in this world, you see. My kind, who are in it for the love of the craft. Who labor on a single piece from dawn to dusk to get it just right. And the other kind, are in it for different reasons. People like Zoltan, whose work is quick and cheap. The kind of smiths who shit out a few hundred blades, reap the profit, and divvy it out among themselves. There wasn't a single day we weren't at each other's throats. But bit by bit, people started taking sides. You would have torn Dravosht in half had it gone on. So, I left.
You didn't have to do that.
Zoltan's a better chief than I would have been. His way of doing things kept food on people's tables. Dravosht prospered without me and my lofty ideals getting in the road. Until the crystals run out at any rate. Without magic to fire the furnaces, this place is as good as dead.
It depends on how you look at it, though. There's got to be other ways of making fire. We manage it in the Deadlands.
Thanks to Sid's ingenuity, yeah. He saw all of this coming. New crystals were the problem, not the solution. And spent years coming up with ways of doing without.
You know what I mean, though, right? Where there's a will, there's a way.
Of course.
What I'm trying to say is that it's not your fault. You couldn't have predicted this.
It doesn't matter whose fault it is. I don't want to be the greatest smith alive just because I happen to be the last. Clive. Dravosht won't last long without his furnaces. So, do you think it's time we shed Sid's bellows with the world? The way I see it, it's your decision to make.
Hold on, Blackthorn. Sid made those things for us. They give us an edge over the rest. And you'd be throwing it away.
All right. Do it. This place was your home. I won't abandon it to its fate.
Fire its fate in forging flames, right?
It was only ever a matter of time before we shared them. Let this be another step on the road to freeing Valisthea from the prison of the Crystal's Blessing. Dravosht will show the world that it's possible. Wouldn't you agree, August?
When you put it that way, of course. It's like hearing Sid speak from beyond the grave.
Thank you, Clive.
Shall I go and fetch the plans, then?
I know I'm off by heart. I'll be needing some help, though. Building a furnace isn't exactly a one-man job. Do us a favor and round up anyone strong enough to lug a brick or two, would you, August?
All right, then.
And I've got a job for you too, Clive. Finding me some salamander skin. I need leather for the bellows and nothing else will withstand the heat. Luckily for us, salamanders feed out in the fields of Carava.
Time for a spot of hunting, man.
Come on.
Came from the wolf. Nah, it didn't make any difference. What was the point of that?
Let's make this quick, shall we?
No mistakes.
Clive's best friend. Damn it, I can never get it, like, it's so instant.
Oh!
Oh wait, I have to do the whole thing again? I just like the idea of being able to just... That should be that by this point. There we go, finally. That took us a little bit while longer than we needed it to.
I dare say that will be enough for a decent set of...
What's this all about then?
Don't know.
Any trouble finding the skin?
Nothing I couldn't handle.
Alright, after this we finally get back onto the story a little bit.
There should be plenty. Right then, time to put these louts to work. If everyone pulls their weight, we'll be finished in no time.
Of course.
Damned! I honestly didn't think it'd work. But it's hot enough, all right. And without a single crystal in sight.
You know what this means, don't you?
I do, yeah. Travoshed is saved.
Sorry about earlier. Take back everything I said. That thing you built us is an honest to God's marvel. You've saved our village.
It's Blackthorn you should be thanking. He oversaw the construction.
Give this to him, would you?
What is it?
Head coal cinders. After he left, I spent years trying to eke the most out of our forges. That there is my answer. Chuck it in the fire, and your forge will burn hotter for longer, which will do wonders for your steel. Our secret for yours. Only fair. I've always envied Blackthorn. Since the day I became chief, I spent every spare moment trying to match up to the bastard. No amount of sleepless nights at the Anvil will ever bridge that gap, though. He's a genius. Plain and simple. most needed. But he took all his talent and left. Gifted and free. Is it any wonder I hate his guts?
The cinders would mean more coming from you.
I need to forgive him first. And that's not gonna happen.
Well, at least it's a start.
Well, you know what they say. Oriflam weren't built in a day and all that.
Wow.
These things take time. Especially when they involve two geezers who hold grudges tighter than their hammers. But what matters is, Blackthorn's got that twinkle back in his eye. And I call that a job well done.
We don't care about anything else.
So would I.
I reckon he's going to be at it a while yet, though, so why don't you head off without us? I'll see that the old git gets home safe and sound.
See that you both do. I'll save the cinders till then.
All right. It'll be a nice little surprise for him.
Finally. Not like bombarded with some new ones, am I? Yeah, I've done all the rest of them. Alright, let's try and finish this up before... This should be the last thing I do today. The Ironworks. Welcome to Monster Hunter World. Oh wow, Joshua is actually doing some heavy lifting.
Are we right, Clive? My dad had it all worked out.
He'd be proud of you, Mid. His writings may have helped, but this achievement is all yours. Can we catch them?
The Einar is one of the largest, fastest vessels ever built. And it won't help she has the wind at her back. Any other ship would be hard pressed to keep pace with her, let alone reel her in. But this isn't any other ship. This is the Enterprise! And the world's never seen anything like my dad's engine.
It certainly hasn't.
Damn. I can see what anybody would care about crushing Midolda.
Of Barnabas Tharm. Only what the bards sing. And he sailed to Ash from southern lands. But it was his mastery of the blade which won him the throne. And that his sword, Odin's sword, can sever the very threads of creation. But don't lose any sleep over a last tilt. We'll do what we must to survive.
We must.
The light! I thought this cove was meant to be hidden!
Please, I hope everybody survives.
Mid! Company!
Eh?
We'll hold them off until the ship is ready. But hurry!
Bullocks! All hands! Man your stations!
I like how things helping. Torgo.
Everyone with me?
The waiting.
It needs every moment we can give her.
Behind me, Lord Rosfield.
I'll take care of these fuckers. Behold! I'll have you know, Earthbreaker here once struck fear into the heart of every man in the Queens.
said that ship was fast!
Oh? I haven't felt this alive in 20 summers. Come on, then. Which of you lot fancies meeting Koga Killer next?
I thought it was called Heartbreaker.
Please don't tell me we don't lose Byron. Oh, okay. That's lame. I was chopped it.
Oh, I died. I didn't realize I died. I got really cocky there. Let me try that again.
Seeing if I could just kill him.
How are we doing, mate? I thought you said that ship was fast. Oh? I haven't felt this alive in 20 summers. Come on, then. Which of you lot fancies meeting Ogre Killer next?
It's called. Not yet. Lord Byron. Where's Joshua? Joshua's just in random quarter.
Thank you.
thank God.
That was so scary.
It was way too scary for what I needed it to be. Everyone pulled their weight on this one.
That was easy enough.
You heard the captain. Clive.
What?
But I thought he was.
Confounded. Then it is as I feared. Sleipnir is no man. But a creation of Odin.
Phoenix's fiery fundament. Have you no normal enemies?
Up for another round?
Of course we are. Right, Lord Rosfield?
A boy, there was a time people called me the executioner.
Or was it my axe?
No matter, heads will roll all the same.
Well, Byron, let's go.
Wait, new plan. You leave, we follow.
Follow? Swimming, are you? Oh, bugger me. Weigh anchor. Engine's dead slow ahead.
Care, my friend. Tis not blood that runs through an agent's veins. These foes will not fall easily.
But they will fall.
Like oaks before a woodman's axe. Good thing I brought one!
Wait. I guess I can't use that tactic. Jeez. I can't use that tactic, can I?
Tis not blood that runs through an Eggie's veins. These foes will not fall easily.
But they will.
Like oaks before a woodman's axe. Good thing I brought one! Get him.
Go on, lad Byron.
How long are we meant to keep this up?
As long as it takes. Unless you have a better idea.
Well, I've already killed at least five of the bastards.
Fuck it. Let's do the lot.
Where is Joshua? This should take out more so. Where's Joshua?
In your own time, Clive!
Come on. Move. We get blah. I can't speak on the other ones. Oh, thank God. Okay, they survived.
Oh.
I'm not gonna lie. I was scared we were gonna die. That scared the crap out of me. Alright, let's just hope Jill is still alive.
What do you want?
That's quite a mess you've made. And wholly unnecessary. You are my offering to Muthos. I would not see you damaged.
Oh, thanks, Flip. At the very least, we know she's not going to be dead for a while. Please don't. Don't do this to me.
I don't suppose Mid has a spare engine. Since you rose from the grave, my fortunes have plummeted. Are you absolutely certain of this quest of yours, Clive? The foes you face are as terrible as they are numerous.
Aye, and they'd have us live and die on their terms, which should answer your question.
You have that same stubborn look as your father did when he set his mind to something. On the battlefield, I am but a single axe. A deadly one, mind, but a single one nonetheless. Yet what you require is 1,000, and I believe my old friend in Randalar can provide them. Take care, Clive. I have many more tales of your father's exploits to share. And I cannot very well do that if you're dead. Again.
Good luck, Uncle. And may fair winds attend you.
As for you, Joshua, take care.
I shall do my best, Uncle.
Farewell, my nephews. When next you see me, it shall be with an army at my back.
I love him so much. Please.
Cheerio.
Let nothing happen to this man.
Keep up, my boy.
Well, we can't have him showing us up now, can we?
We would never hear the end of it.
I love Byron. Byron is so cool.
Mercy.
fight.